Okay. October 28 today. 2015, we're in the New Testament. Old Testament's a good example, but we live by the New Testament. We're not in the shadow, we're in the substance. And so many things have changed now that we're in the substance. So we're going to go to the writings of Galatians. Galatians chapter 2. And we're going to start reading in verse 14. But when I saw that they were not straightforward about the truth of the gospel, just bear with me there for a minute. I'll just get my act together here. Well, it's not really an act, it's a reality. Get my reality together. Galatians 2:14, but when I saw that they were not straightforward about the truth of the gospel, I said to Peter before them all, if you being a Jew live in the manner of Gentiles and not as the Jews, why do you compel Gentiles to live as Jews? We who are Jews by nature and not sinners of the Gentiles, knowing that a man is not justified by the works of the law, but by faith in Jesus the Christ, even we have believed in Jesus the Christ, that we might be justified by faith in Christ and not by the works of the law. For by the works of the law no flesh shall be justified, but if, while we seek to be justified by Christ, we ourselves also are found sinners, is Christ therefore a minister of sin? Certainly not. For if I build again those things which I destroyed, I make myself a sinner automatically. Verse 19, for I through the law died to the law that I might live to God. I have been crucified with the Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. Final verses 21. I do not set aside the grace of God, the power of God, for if righteousness came through the law, then Christ died in vain. Jesus did not die in vain, did he? No. So our message today, the title of our message today is Straight Forward. Straight Forward. And the Spirit of God quickened that word to me in verse 14 of Galatians 2. When I saw that they were not straight forward about the truth of the gospel, I said to Peter before them all, if you being a Jew live in the manner of Gentiles, not as the Jews, why do you compel Gentiles to live as Jews? There's really a lot in these verses, isn't there? There's so much. I don't believe I could exhaust it, you know. I don't believe I could tell all. I know in part and I preach in part. But what I'm going to say here today is, this section is actually talking, as Galatians does, the whole epistle, going forward, going backwards, or maybe mixing the brew a bit, you know. I think that would sum up Galatians, going forward, going backwards, or mixing the brew. And we know that's not good. Galatians 3:1, O foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you that you should not obey the truth? Before whose eyes Jesus the Christ was clearly portrayed among you as crucified. And we have a lot of that today, don't we? We have a lot of people out there endeavouring to bewitch us. And they're on a witch and a warlock hunt, and they're trying to deter us from the road called straight. Hey. You see, there's a lot of people going forward, and I know people I've known many years ago, even at school maybe, and they've gone forward. And it even looks like they've gone far more forward than I have. They really seem to be, you know, gathering the possessions, setting themselves up for life, as they say. Well, I believe they're setting themselves up, but not for life, for death, an eternal living death. What if you gain all the things of the world and all the friendships of the world, and in the process lose your soul to the devil? So that's where the bewitching comes in. See? And the Galatians, as we see in Galatians chapter 1, the churches at Galatia, these were Jews, and they had come to the Lord. They had come to the Lord. Galatians 4. Galatians 4 and verse 8. But then indeed, when you did not know God, you served those things which by nature are not God. But now, after you have known God, or rather are known by God, how is it that you turn again to the weak and beggarly elements to which you desire again to be in bondage? Weak and beggarly. That's how the Apostle Paul described Judaism and described the way of the law and described the world. Weak and beggarly. It's not for us. We weren't designed to be beggars and to be servants of materialism and religion. All this week on the street and one-on-one, every person I met, I couldn't help but ask them, do you really want to be religious or do you want to be right with God? Which one do you want? Because you can't be both. Paul saying to the Galatians, you can't be both. You can't be right with God and remain religious and trying to work your own way to heaven. We know there's three lots of works, isn't there? There's the works of the law. Paul talks about in Galatians. There's the works of good deeds. And then there's the first work. And the Galatians fell short with the first works, didn't they? They fell short with the first works, as did the Ephesians. They came to the Lord, and then they missed their fair-weathered friends. They missed their religion. And how many I know come out of religion and denominationalism and demonizationalism and all kinds of man-made organizations, but yet they go back. And as I initially said about Galatians, it's a combination of going forward, going backwards, or the mix. And that's the only other alternative if we don't want the straight road, is the mix. You'll never ever experience what God has for you. No one can ever experience that heavenly touch. No one can experience the heavenly touch unless we stay on the straight and narrow. See? So the title of our message today is Straight Forward. As I said, many are going forward, but on the crooked road. and all sorts of pain and heartache is theirs because of that. If we're going to make it to the pearly gates, if we're going to get sight of the gates of light, it's the way of the cross. It's the way that the Lord has prepared for us. He paved the way with his blood. You know, just follow the dots. Follow the blood trail on the road called straight. But when I saw that they were not straightforward about the truth of the gospel, I said to Peter before them all, openly in front of everyone. Paul was a straight shooter. He was a real messianic shirt fronter, wasn't he? He was just up front. That's what I like about Paul. And he had a good eye. He had a good eye in the spirit, and he could see clearly, hang on, Peter, there's something not going right here. This is not helpful. We know, according to the book of Acts, we know very clearly what it says there about the apostles. Let's go to Acts and 20. Let's go there and have a look there. See what it says. Acts 20. Paul the Apostle. Acts 20. Verse 20. This is 2020 vision. As I said, Paul could see very clearly. It's a gift of God. He had that supernatural discernment. He could see clear as the gold on the streets of the New Jerusalem. Acts 20:20. I kept nothing back that was helpful. Proclaim it to you and taught you publicly, house to house, testifying to Jews and Greeks alike, repentance towards God, and then faith towards our Lord Jesus, the Christ. See that? There's two things there in verse 21 that Paul emphasizes, repentance. Repentance. Repentance, and then it has to be. And I always see that next bit as stretch. It's like a road. Faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. Going forward in the faith by faith. So we're going to have to be straightforward as of this day, this very day, if we're going to make it. If we're going to finish this messianic marathon correctly, and the same if we love our neighbor as we love ourselves. And you would not like anyone to lead you astray, would you? I know I wouldn't. I'd be very angry with them. There's multitudes of angry mobs. Tens of millions are going to be gnashing their teeth at the Joel Osteens and the Joyce Myers and the Benny Hinns of the world in hell. In hell. Because they've gone forward with a gospel, not the gospel. The Lord said clearly that this gospel must be preached in every nation. This gospel, and he described what do you mean, which gospel? This gospel, the gospel of another planet. It's not the gospel of materialism. Peter was a stickler for materialism. He said, we've given up everything, and what do we get now, Lord? Lord said, you have to wait for the regeneration if you want to be with me. It's not about materialism, Pedro. Someone say amen if you want to. Yeah? And the people today, according to scripture, are sticklers for materialism. Some, you know, most people, the large majority of people, find their comfort in material surrounds. That's where their security is. But we know, as the Spirit has shown us, that is a demic hallucination. That's an illusion. That's a mirage in a earthly desert. Because what you have, if that's your security, it can be gone overnight. And we're seeing earthquake after earthquake, aren't we? All over the world, bang one after the other, bang bang, Philippines, North America, and what was the latest one? It was, say again?
Afghanistan.
And even here in their own country of Australia, individual places being struck with great power. Fernvale only last night just smashed the place. And I know a brother, and there's certain people trying to break up his marriage, and they live in Fernvale. And we've been praying. Oh, look, the Lord, he got the same scriptures as I got this morning. In Thessalonians chapter 1, 2 Thessalonians 1, I think it was 6. And just let me interrupt by just reading that. The same, very same scriptures that these people who are gossiping and trying to destroy this man's marriage. We can go to 2 Thessalonians, hallelujah, glory to the Lamb. 2 Thessalonians, man from Galilee, love that man from Galilee. Yeah, 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, and starting in verse 6, it's the right thing and a righteous thing with God to repay with trouble those who trouble his followers, and to give that those who have been troubled by them rest with the apostles when Jesus comes again with his mighty angels. Someone say amen.
Amen.
So there's a bit of waiting there too. Right? Title of a message today, straightforward. Look, we're going to get to the gates of light, the pearly gate. We've got to go forward on the straight road. We have to talk straight. If you love your neighbour, you tell them straight. But we know that they're calling evil good and good evil. And if you're straight laced today and straightforward, you're called hateful, unloving. You're called everything in the devil's dictionary. Someone say amen. Right? And why do you think they put Jesus on the tree, crucified him? Because he was a straight shooter. He called a spade, not a great big shovel. Anyway, when I saw that they were not straightforward about the truth of the gospel, I said to Peter in front of everyone, see, about the truth of the gospel. See, we have to have the truth. We have to have the true gospel. There's a lot of gospels out there. Gospel means message. A lot of gospels out there. A lot of Jesus's. A lot of spirits. Right? We've got to get the right one. And we know the right one lines up with what's in God's book. This is not man's Bible. The Bible is not man's book. It's God's book. And it's intact. I don't care about translations. If you want the bona fide, get the translator. It don't matter what translation you pick up. He's going to rectify it and take up the slack. Glory to the Lamb, eh? But, you know, we've got a world today. Oh, that's where the blessing is, you know. That's where the blessing is. You know, given, it'll be given back to you, pressed down, shaken together over. That's true. It's more blessed to give than receive. But what about your soul? Is obedience optional to salvation? No, it's not. It's not. We must obey if we're going to be saved. Paul was pulling Peter up real quick. He said, "But when I saw that they were not straightforward about the truth of the gospel, I said to Peter before them all, 'If you being a Jew, a so-called God lover,'" I'm paraphrasing here, "'and you live in the manner of the Gentiles, like sinners or pagans, and not as the Jew, so-called holy people, why do you compel Gentiles, sinners or unholy ones, to live as the Jews, the holy ones?'" You listening? This is... There seems to be a bit of a contradiction here. You know, there's a lot of bragging about being a Jew and being of the Jewish race. But we know that God tells us clearly there's no Jew or Greek in Christ. Right? We know that there's no Jew or Gentile in Christ. And though the Jews be as the sand of the sea, only a remnant will be saved. These are the ones that go straight forward. No malingering or dilly-dallying. Straightforward. Home to glory. Eh? And these go home by the way of the cross. Only Sunday we looked at enemies of the cross. The moment you decide to decrease and humble yourself under the mighty hand, / doctrine of Jesus, you're gonna have enemies. And at the end of the day, they're not really your enemies, they're his enemies, Jesus' enemies. They're enemies of the cross. They're enemies of what Jesus done at the cross. That's the devil's behind that. See? Once you put people on the straight and narrow and you give them the good oil, there's not a lot of money to be made, really. They're filled with the Holy Ghost and they can start to see, and you can't waylay and cause these people to err with course after course after course and going to Bible college and learning to be a reverend doctor, father, mother, and when we know very well that the straight talk of Paul the Apostle to the Ephesians in Ephesians 4:11 says that you're either gifted or you're not. John backs it up and says, you haven't got it from above, you don't have it, go back to the sawmill or the cannery or whatever. Someone say amen. See? There's no money in the truth. But there is eternal riches. Eternal joy. Eternal peace. Infinite blessing in the Lord Jesus. Can't count it. Fresh, beautiful every day. Title of our message is straightforward. If we're going to get to glory, look, you've got hair straighteners out there. You've got teeth straighteners, braces they call it, leg straighteners. But what about the character straightener? Hey? the great stain remover, the blood of Jesus. Eh? What about the character straightener? Eh? Character straightener. I think we can go right, rightfully to Hebrews now. Hebrews. Eh? I see this old dog-eared Bible of mine. Dear, dear, can't even read the verse. It's been handled that much. I've mauled it away just about. Hebrews 12, let's go to verse 11 with the character straightener. Now the chastening... No chastening seems to be joyful for the present, but painful. Nevertheless, afterward it yields the peaceable fruit of knowing that you're glory bound, of righteousness to those who have been trained by it. Peaceable fruit. You have peace. If you let the Lord chastise you, correct you, give you a good thumping. Hey? You got that piece about being on the straight and narrow, moving forward, no bother about the perils of not progressing, no bother about going back, no bother about, oh, I might mix the wine a dab, it's getting a bit hard. No, straight forward, stopping no stations, hey, straight to glory. On the Hallelujah Express. Dear, dear, dear. Whoo! Glory. Glory. Okay, the gospel of the truth of the gospel is it's not about getting, it's about giving up, isn't it? Give up. Give up and you won't suicide. Give up your life to Jesus and you won't be loaded with heartache and bitterness and disappointment. You'll understand. The Lord said there's great joy in that, in Jeremiah. He says, don't glory in your knowledge and wisdom and earthly riches, but glory in that you know me. Right? And you understand me. See, the biggest problems in the world have arisen because they don't understand God. Oh, God done this. God done that to my mother and God took my child away. And God done this and God done that. Well, he took the child away because he knew you wouldn't be able to raise it properly. Someone say amen. What? We don't want to hear that. I'm a bit too straight, aren't I? We're not going to raise the children up in the way of the Lord. We're going to raise them up to go forward on the crooked road to hell. Right? And the Lord don't want that because he's a God of love. And he knows the heart. And he knows who's who in the religious zoo. And those who are outside the gate suffering the reproach of the Christ. Willingly. So most are proceeding forward without caution. They're on a crooked road. And the pain that they're suffering is just unspeakable. And I've been there. I've been just full speed ahead, you know. Drinking, cursing and swearing and full speed ahead, you know, travelling down that highway, faster than the speed of sound. Eh? Yes. Hebrews 12 and the verse is 11. Now, no chastening seems to be joyful for the present, but painful. Painful? Oh, that doesn't sound like Jesus. Maybe not doesn't sound like your Jesus. That's the Bible, Jesus. Nevertheless, afterward, it's going to yield a crop, and it's going to be singing sweet hallelujahs in the sweet corns. Someone say amen. And you're going to know because, not because you know. Oh, I know because I know because I know. Weak, that's weak. That's very doubtful, you know, because you know, because you know, because you know, because you're the only one in there, and I haven't heard Jesus yet because you know, and you know, and you know because you know. I'm going to heaven because I know, because I know. No, I'm going to heaven because Jesus said so. He said, if you do this, you will end up in heaven. If you do this, you will have peace that surpasses the understanding of the mind. If you do this, you'll have joy unspeakable. If you do this, you will not want for any good thing for the rest of your day. If you do this, you won't have to worry about what you're going to eat, because I provide for the birds, I'll provide for you too. If you do this, you will be able to deliver many. You'll be instrumental. You'll be more than an overcomer. If you're on the straight and narrow, but difficult is the road, right? Difficult be the way on the straight. Hebrews 12, verses 12. Therefore strengthen the hands which hang down and the feeble knees. Make straight paths for your feet, so that what is lame may not be dislocated, but rather healed. See? Only the straight road heals. How can you mend this broken heart? How can a loser ever win? Ask Jesus to give you another heart. He's got heaps of them. He said he'll take the stony one and put it in the rock pile. You'll crush that up later on. Make a few new ones. You get a new heart. I'll put in you a new heart. I'll put in you a new heart. One that wants to do what I say. Okay? And you might be struggling in yourself trying to keep the law of Buddha or the law of Muhammad or the law of the Pope or the law of a mythical Mary or the law of 600... Hail mythical Marys, or I'll pray, you know, 20 times a day. I'll headbutt the floor, you know, twice before lunch, two after, or I'll walk a million miles for one of your smiles, mammy. No, yeah. You've got to do all these things and jump through the hoops and loops. But still no better off. Just false humility and religions of men and women. It's best to take faith and live by faith in the Son of God, going forward on the straight road, the doctrine of the Christ. And then we're not worried. We're not all panicky and worried. I've got to go overseas because my uncle's cousin's mother's sister of 25th cousin removed of my great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather is going to die soon and I want him to go to heaven. Hello? Are you for real? You don't trust God? That you're the only person in the world? You don't believe Jesus has someone over there that's already told him 100 times? Repent? You don't believe that? And you're neglecting your own family there and running hither and thither for one proselyte? Someone say amen. You religious thing? Nah. Faith! 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 Sometimes people go overseas and they say, oh, I'm going to preach the gospel. And they get there and they say, oh, no. And the walls start to close in a little bit, you know? And they don't want to be embarrassed, or they don't want this. And, oh, well, I don't want to, you know. and nothing's ever even hardly said. You're better off staying at home and praying. As if your prayers get past the roof. Someone say amen. Right? I'm a bit straightforward today, aren't I? Getting a bit too straightforward. Right? Paul was right up front in front of everyone. He said, listen, Peter, you're on the wrong road, mate. You're supposed to be preaching Jesus here. Right? You're telling these Gentiles to go and be a Jew and become a Jew and become and follow the Judaic teachings. We're supposed to be telling people about Jesus and following him by faith. Let's get it straight. Let's get it right. And then we can go forward and progress and go from glory to glory and strength to strength, right? Why do you compel Gentiles to live as Jews? Right? Why do you compel Gentiles to live as Jews? Boy, oh boy. Galatians chapter 2, and to live as Jews. Verse 15, we who are Jews by nature and not sinners of the Gentiles. See, now it's got nothing to do with nature. Now we're super nature. Right? It's got nothing anymore to do with human nature. It's all about the Spirit now. The book of Acts. Let's go there. Acts. Let's go to the Acts. That weren't really Acts, but happening. Acts 2 and verse 29. Acts chapter 2, verse 29. Oh, sorry, not Acts. Romans, sorry. What am I doing? What are you thinking? No. What was he thinking at that time? Might have a look at that scripture anyway. Later. Romans 2, 29. He is a Jew who is one inwardly, and circumcision is that of the heart in the spirit, not in the letter of the law, whose praise is not from man but from God. And that holds a lot of people back from going straight and forward. People wanting the praise of men and women rather than the praise of God. Holds many back. And I believe these Jews that we're reading about in Galatians here, 2:14-21, or Galatians itself, I believe they loved the praises. They never shook it off their feet like a serpent. They just kept hanging in there. It's a great snare. I mean, it did come from Eve, because that's what the devil done for Eve. He praised her, didn't he? He put her right up there next to God. He said, you'll be just like God. She thought, wow, me? Really, Mr. Lizard? Yes, you'll be just like him. Do you really think I can? I'm sure you can. Huh? A lot of trouble starts with that line, doesn't it? You really think I can? Yeah. Oh, of course you can. Boy, oh boy. The world's in a mess because of that. The world's in a mess because they don't want to go straight forward. They want to go forward. But they don't want to go the way of the Lord. See? That's why the world is in the mess it's in. They don't mind. They say, look, we'll have a mix. Have a mix. Won't go back. You know. We won't go forward. Let's just settle for a mix. And we'll call it going forward. What about that one? Yeah. And we'll have a, like, you know, like multicultural religion sort of thing. Like one world conglomerate, you know, one world religion, one world church sort of thing. they're not going back, they're not going forward, they're just going round in circles, aren't they? And it's going around the globe right now, isn't it? The Muslims with the Christians, I'm glad I'm not a Christian, I tell you. Muslims with the Christians and the Baha'i and the Boohoo and the Buddhists and the, you know, the Mother Teresa is, and everyone's coming together, you know, over the devil and everything, all this community cohesion, you know, and this false religion fusion. It's all coming together. But the Lord says today by the Spirit, through this message, which is 11 years old, he says again through this message, he says, no, go straight forward like Jesus went straight forward when they were trying to throw him over the cliff. And he said, excuse me, chaps, I have work to do. And he walked through the midst, straight forward through the midst of them. Someone say amen. Amen. And that's what the word of God, the doctrine of Jesus will do for you and me and all who would call upon his name, crying out for might that they may fight the fight of faith for Father to the finish. It'll take us straight through the midst. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Got any rivers you think are uncrossable? Got any mountains you can't tunnel through? My God specializes. My God, he specializes in things thought impossible. He'll do for you what no other power can do. He'll do that through the word, see? Hey? He'll do that through the power of the word on faith obedience with an injection of Holy Ghost. See? That's the only way. So we're going to go into the message now and we're going to deconstruct that word strength. Oh, hallelujah. So we know how we're going to go forward. Hey? And we'll go forward like bullets. Hey? We'll run fast. We'll run fast. The Lamb of God. Hey? Everyone's looking for the material blessing. They're all material girls in a material world. Aren't they? Right? And that seems to make them happy. But then the material things, whatever made them happy, gets a bit dull and might break or fall apart or whatever. Someone steals it, the car or something. Cyclone comes and just rips the roof off that lovely little house and just smashes everything inside, and there's mud up to your knees and everyone's sitting around crying. And the salvos are out there patting them on the back saying, it'll be all right. We got Jats here and plenty of ham. Processed, of course. And we're going to sit with you all the way through so that you can rebuild, get back on that crooked road again. All the way to hell. And because it happened at this time of the year, well, I think Sandy might even have something for you. Yeah. On that crooked road. Yeah? Oh, foolish Galatians. Oh, foolish Galatians. Do you really think that good deeds are going to cut it, the mustard with Jesus? Do you really think that good works, do you really think struggling to keep the law is going to cut the mustard when Jesus nailed it all on the tree? Okay? All those handwritings. And he empowered, opened up the door of faith so that we could believe and receive the power to not just overcome, but to be more than overcomers. Okay? That's what he has done. He has made us more than overcomers. That's going into the teaching realm. That's going into the mentoring, messianic mentoring. Without Bible college, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. By my Spirit. Remember the seven spirits of the Lord in one. Ten commandments brought down to two. Three in one. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Seven spirits of the Lord. You got counsel in there and you got power and might. Hey? Got everything there. Let's have a look. Get every one of them and then you'll know what you got. Let's go to Isaiah. The prophet Isaiah. Glory to the Lamb of God. Right? Glory to the Lamb. Galilee Lamb. Isaiah. Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 11 verse 1. There shall come from a, there shall come forth a rod from the stem of Jesse. A branch shall grow out of his roots. Talking about Jesus. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him. The Spirit of wisdom, the Spirit of understanding, the Spirit of counsel, might, knowledge, and the fear of Father. Come on. All in one we have. Now all we need to do is cut them loose. Hallelujah. On faith, obedience. Whoo! On faith, obedience. We have those seven spirits in one. Captured in the Holy Ghost. You see what I mean? There's no excuse for not being an overcomer or more than an overcomer. Could we have the Spirit? We have the Spirit of the Lord. Glory. Hallelujah. We have wisdom and understanding. This is godly wisdom. Godly understanding, godly counsel, godly might. How mighty is that? As the Lord said the same thing to another one of his children, Gideon, go in the might that I have given you. Hallelujah. That messianic might. Not veggie might, but messianic might. Hallelujah. Who? And then we run paths. All those little Vegemites, don't we? And we just keep running. And we go straight forward. Hitting the bullseye. Hallelujah. Right? Straight forward is our message today. And we're going to go into that message right now. And we're going to have a look at the word straight. So as I said initially, a lot of people think you're angry, hateful man if you're straight with people. But the S in straight stands for sympathetic toward the sinner. That's when you're straight, you're actually being sympathetic. You're sympathizing with the sinner and their wounds and their twisted ankles. And you know what it's like to have a twisted ankle? I know what it's like to have a twisted ankle. I got a reoccurring injury on one of my ankles. Oh, when I roll him over. Dear. Ouchie. And make straight path for your feet so that what is lame may not be dislocated. Hallelujah. See? But heal. And the people of the world, when you look in the spirit, I always see them with, you know, like when you see those cartoons with the cat or the road runner and the fox, and he makes all these explosives and he blows up and he's got all these patches on him and he's got bandages all over him. That's what I see the world, the people in the world. I see the lawyers, the doctors, the butchers, the bakers, the candlestick makers. They're all patched up and they've got all sorts of broken limbs because they're on a crooked road. They're not on the straight road. Hey? They're still soldiering on with Codrell rather than Jesus. Hey? They got all sorts of drama. They don't have peace because they're not under the chastening hand. No one sympathizes with them and says, oh, look, I've got to help you. I really have to help you. Please, get on this road that I'm on and you'll be not happy, heavenly happy. Get on this road. Okay? You're on the road to hell. You're on the highway to hell. So when you're straightforward, like Paul was with Peter, he didn't mess around. He's saying, look, you're as bad as these Galatians yourself. You're backtracking. You're mixing the broom. Can you say amen? There's no mix. Oh, we're Judaic Christians. Oh, come on. You're either a saint or you're not. You know, Judaic Christian. Everyone, all glorifying the Jews, you know. Half the time I think I've seen people leave so-called Christian fellowships and Messianic fellowships and join Jewish groups. And the Jews relish in that. They love that. We know all the way through the Bible that they relished in who they were more than they relished in who God was. And you know that they're still in the flesh and they're still under law. We know the Jews are like that and they just don't have any time for Jesus because you got all these, Holocaust Remembrance Day. In other words, we haven't forgotten. Oh, what was that? You haven't forgiven? Oh, righto. Even Pentecostals and Orthodox, they're trying to stitch that Holocaust together with Jesus. I think he was more like the one that wiped them out. Did they die in the name of Jesus? Or in the name of their law? Did those Jews, were they crucified by Hitler and the Nazis because of Jesus? No, I don't believe so. Because every time I've seen anything to do with the Holocaust, none of them mention Jesus. It's a no-no. So we need to get straight, don't we? Oh, Ronnie Barker was going straight there for a while, wasn't he? And porridge. But he wasn't going straight with Jesus. He didn't have the real straight. He just had Granville. Hey? The real straight. I tell you, the straight is straight. Sober is sober. Oh, you better believe it. Some women say, oh, this is my husband. His name's Bill. And he doesn't drink. He's straight. You know, he doesn't drink. But he's not straight. He's a thief. Someone say amen. Huh? He's sober. He's a sober man. No, he's not. He's drunk with lies. He don't have the truth. Someone say amen. I love the smell of rice paper in the morning. Right? You don't want the truth. You can't handle the truth. Right? So, those who are going straight forward are loving people. They have the love of God and they sympathize with the sinner. They tell them their sin. Tell my people their sin. Hey? Tell, that's the scriptures, isn't it? That's the Old Testament prophets. Tell my people their sin. Jeremiah, wasn't it? Hey? Tell my people their sin. Blow the trumpet in the land. Put thy trumpet to thy mouth. Tell my people their sin. If the trumpet makes an uncertain sound, how will the people know to prepare to wage war with the devil? Uncertain. Not straight, see? It's not straight. You've got to be straight. To the point. Call a spade, not a great big shovel. Someone say amen. S-T-R-A-I-G-H-T. S-T-R-A-I-G-H-T. The T. People who are straightforward are very thankful. Thankful to Jesus. Very, very thankful and grateful to Jesus. So much, they talk straight. Very straight. Paul said, you're not being grateful to Jesus, Peter. Paul said, you're not sympathizing with these Jews talking like that to them, Peter, at all. It's not helping them. I held back nothing. That was helpful. I gave them the full counsel. I have not shunned to proclaim the full counsel of God, someone say amen. S-T-R-A-I-G-H-T. Straightforward people are the only people that will ever be right with God. Ever. Because Jesus said, let your yes be yes and your no be no. Anything else is of the devil. No, hum, ha, I don't really know. It could be, I don't know, maybe. Just to get yourself off the hook because there's a few people eyeballing you. Can someone say amen? They're looking down on you, you know. They're giving you the, you know, the evils, so to speak. Well, we're, you know, they're giving you that look. Well, we're waiting to hear what you have to say. Those sort of people, you go over and rub noses with them and say, this is what I'm going to say. I'm glad you're hungry to listen. And then you look in their eyes and say, hey, I'm a straightforward person because I'm on the straight and narrow and I'm glory bound and I'm sympathizing with you and the rest of the crooks here, sinners here. So I'm not going to get out of beat with my God because of you or anyone else. In this hell-bound family, someone say amen. This is the way it's going to be. Hey? We'll be riding on the horses, yeah. On the plain of ghetto, little darling. We'll be riding with Jesus that day on the plain of Megiddo. Fight the battle of battles. darkness and light, and we will win if we are straightforward people and we tell it the way it is. T-R-A. Straightforward people make a path for themselves. The A is for A. The A is for ability. When you're straightforward and you tell it the way it is and you walk in the word, you are given the ability to overcome. You are given the ability to do everything that Jesus said. But he never grants the ability to anyone that's crooked. We have to be straightforward. We have to be straight with him. Jesus cannot help crooks that want to stay crooks. He can't help them. They just keep going around in circles, just like the One World Church. Just like the globe itself, keep going round and round and round and round and round. They never go straight forward. They're selfish people. They don't sympathise that there's people going to hell forever. Unless they tell them the truth. We have to tell people the truth. That's what Paul was saying to Peter. You're not telling them the truth, Peter. You're not sympathising with them by telling them lies and compromising with them and mixing the brew. You're not helping them one bit. Right? You're just not helping them. Glory to the Lamb, hey? S-T-R-A. I. People are straightforward. They are illuminated. They have the light because they're straightforward. They love being straightforward. They love the straight road. They love the narrow road. They love Jesus. Jesus illuminates their understanding. He gives them light. He gives them continuous, ongoing revelation knowledge. You see people who hum-ha around the place. Come on. Peter couldn't see what he was doing. But Paul could. When I saw that they were not straightforward, Peter and the others with him, compromising. And Peter couldn't see how serious it was because he wasn't being straightforward. We always make exceptions and we make concessions for family, friends. We make all sorts of excuses for our husband or our wife or our children. We make all these excuses, and at the same time, we're not loving them by telling them the truth of being straightforward with them. That is not love. It's not love, I tell you now. And some people, they just don't want to be thrown out. They just don't want to be cut off. They want it both ways. They want their cake and eat it too. They want, as they say, the best of both worlds. Impossibility. Impossibility. According to Scripture, not according to me, according to Scripture, impossibility. You cannot walk in two directions at the same time. You are either on the wide, crooked road or you're on the narrow, straight road. No person can walk in two directions at the same time. That person is self-deceived. We have to make our decision, don't we? So, the reality is obedience optional to salvation? in order to be saved. Right? We have to be on the straight road. There's only one road that leads to heaven, and it's called straightforward. There's no other road. There's no other road. Galatians 4 in verse 8. Then indeed you did not know God, you served those which by nature are not God. After you have known God, or rather been known by God, how is it that you turn again to the weak and beggarly elements to which you desire again to be in bondage? You observe days, months, seasons and years. I am afraid for you, lest I have labored for you in vain. Hey? What do you reckon about that? Days, months and seasons. Going backwards. And the religious people love that, like the Jews loved it. And they're still doing it today. And they've got all their feasts and this and that and this and that. But we don't see Paul or Peter or Jude or Matthew or Mark or Luke. We don't see any of them promoting days and months and seasons. We don't see the Christmas season. We don't see the Easter parade in the Bible. We don't see the worshipping of birthdays in the Bible. Only two, and they were pagan kings or something, weren't they? Yeah. We don't see, because we don't see it there, because it's all connected with self and the crooked road. Whereas the way of the Lord clears us and separates us from all of that to give us a clean, clear run, straight forward. And we empty ourselves of all these things that waylay us along the way, you know, the wiles of the devil, I reckon. Last night on television, on SBS, they had on Inside, I think it was, and they were talking about becoming a man. And one guy said he'd become a man when he was circumcised of the flesh. Another bloke said he became a man when he got all his tattoos all over him. Another guy said he became a man when he started to go through some ritual and put a bag over his head or something. Fast. Another one became a man when he started to bring a bit of coin into the house and look after the people. But none of that's true, is it? According to Scripture, not one of them. And oh, they're having a great time. They put it on the boil, and what it turned out was you just make your own belief. Anything goes, you know. And there wasn't one person to set them straight. Not even the head of the program. What was other? Julie, someone, I don't know. I can't remember her name. Not really interested, but none of them. You know, they all thought they were going to do wonders with a bag of eggs and a stick. And none of them could make an omelette. But the thing is, no one wanted to be straight and say, look, there's only one way to be a man. Real men don't sin willfully. Real women don't sin, either. The Lord told us through Paul, godly women. They're not big mouth, abusive, demanding Jezebels. They're quiet and gentle. They don't need to wear a micro skirt to draw men. Their gentleness and kindness and quietness will stun the man. They'll be mulleted. instead of seeing some woman standing there with a micro skirt on and all the fruit hanging out the top, mouthing off, drunk, wanting to punch some bloke out. Oh, that's a turn on, isn't it? Wow, that really, oh, I'd like to marry her. You'd be a nut. You'd be a crunchy nut, for sure. I'd be getting, borrowing someone's car to do some burnout to get out of there. Quiet, gentle spirit. There's some big loud mouth woman, ah, yeah, I'm telling you, you know, they're all out for self. All out for self. Only one way to be a man and a woman, and that's to follow Jesus. No one else. There's all schisms and holes, and the buckets have holes in them anywhere else. Jesus said, I am the way. We're on the straight and narrow here today, STRAI. Illuminated. Got the light on the situation. And it's not dark light either. STRAIG. Those who talk straight forward, those who are straightforward people on the narrow and the straight and narrow, the G is for glory bound. G for glory. They're forever saying glory. And they're forever. You know, when you're in love, that's the only one you ever talk about is the one you're in love with. You know he done this, you know he done that. Oh, well, he is. Because you're in love with the Jewish king. You can say amen or oh my. And he is your boast and your bestie. He is your everything. And you're glory bound. Right? People who are straightforward and they're on the straight and narrow, they're going to be able to lead others to be glory bound. Right? Peter wasn't glory bound. He was rebuked by Paul. He said, listen, you got the wrong mindset here. What's going on? What are you saying? What do you think you're doing? You can't go doing that. We've got to stick with the blueprint, mate. Hey? And it's not good deeds. It's not the law. It's not the tithing. And it's not the coin. It's faith. Faith, obedience in Jesus the Christ. Someone say amen. By Holy Ghost power. Hey? Holding nothing back. Proclaiming the full counsel of the Lord. Hey? Holding back nothing that is helpful. STRAIGH. H is for heavenly happy. Those who are on the straight and narrow are heavenly happy. They're not happy. People in the world, they can be happy for a few minutes or a day or two or a week or two, depending on the situation. And then it's back to the old grumble. It's back to the old, back to the past. It's, you know, back to the whinging or back to the preparing to die, you know. They might have on a coffin, you know, because he's a cricket player, they make it into a cricket bat or something. And you're going to go to heaven and ignore Jesus all his life. You know? Or a great radio announcer, he's going to have a coffin the shape of a microphone. He'll be going to microphone heaven or something. That's how deluded, see? Because no one has ever been straightforward with them. No one has ever told them there is no rock and roll heaven. If you believe in heaven, if you believe in heaven, life is just a one-night stand. That's all life is, just a one-night stand. Hey? There's no rock and roll heaven. There's no doggy heaven or puppy heaven or pussycat heaven. Hey? There's only heaven. And Noah, myself included, will never, ever see heaven and the New Jerusalem unless we get on the straight, narrow. That's it. Stay there. Get on there and stay there. Someone say amen. Amen. Then you'll be glory bound. Heavenly happy. Heavenly happy. Even as Job said, I know the day is coming when I will see God in this body. I know my Redeemer lives. Right? Glory, hallelujah. I know, Job 19, if my memory is serving me well. I know my Redeemer lives. Hey? I know my Redeemer lives. I'm just going to go over to Job there. Have a quick look at that 19. It's one of my favourites. Job 19. I know. 1925 wasn't a bad year. For I know that my Redeemer lives. Job 19:25, and he shall stand at last on the earth, and after my skin is destroyed, this I know, that in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. How my heart yearns within me for God. Shikamarasan. Come on. You like that?
Yeah.
His flesh is going to be removed. He means he's going to see God even manifesting in himself. Be an immortal being. Glory. Hallelujah. Heavenly happy. Heavenly. Those who are straightforward. And this is our final letter in the word straight. And a powerful, powerful word. As we deconstructed this word straight. The T. Powerful. People who are straightforward and treat not their life dear to themselves, they've been touched by God. Just like Paul on the road to Damascus. On the Damascus road, he was touched. The Lord pumped him and knocked him off the horse, flat on his back. King hit him. King Jesus hit him. Bonk. Who are you? Who are you? I really want to know who are you. I am Jesus of Nazareth. I am Jesus whom you are persecuting. Get rid of the good deeds and the law and follow me. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. By faith, obedience in the Son of God. Dear, right there. I've been touched. To get a touch from the Lord is so real. To get a touch from the Lord is so real. If you draw near to Him, He will draw near to you. I tell you what, let's sing that song. Amen. Let's sing that song. To get a touch from the Lord. To get a touch. From the Lord is so real. Come on now. To get a touch from the Lord is so real. If you draw near to Him. If you draw near to Him. He will draw near to you. To get a touch from the Lord. Get a touch from the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Get a touch from the Lord is Get a touch from the Lord is all straightforward, Lord. You taught us to love our neighbor. Sympathize, Lord, with the sinner. And to be thankful and grateful to you, Lord. Oh, that we are in right standing with you, Lord. Then we're able to overcome. Oh, illuminated by your word, Lord. Glory bound. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Heavenly happy. Oh, hallelujah. My Jesus is coming. He's coming again. Hallelujah. Touched by you, Lord. Get a touch from you is so real, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You're so wonderful, Lord. We know that the only way, the loving way, is to be straightforward. And we thank you for teaching us that. Everybody said, amen. And amen and amen.